Greetings. Let's quickly review Deedat's theory and his proof for his theory.
Let me reread to you this verse with a little emphasis on the pronouns. He says, I have yet many things to say unto you, but he cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak from himself, but what things shall he hear, that shall he speak, and he shall declare unto you the things that are to come. He shall glorify me. 8 masculine pronouns in one verse. I say, it ill befits a ghost. You agree? That is a man, a man, a man, a man. 8 times. There is not another verse in the whole Bible with 8 masculine pronouns or 8 feminine gender or 8 neuter genders. There isn't. This is a unique verse for a unique personality, Muhammad. Man, 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 not a ghost, not a spook.
John 16:13 has 8 masculine pronouns. That makes this verse unique. There is not another verse in the whole Bible. Not 8 masculine, not 8 feminine, not 8 neutral. This makes the verse unique. Unique. There is not another verse like it in the whole Bible. Gee, that's step 2 in the proof. That would seem important to me. Kind of critical, this whole uniqueness. Big thanks to Sold Out for Jesus 37 for doing the legwork and keeping his eyes and ears open. 1 Samuel 17:40. And he took his staff in his hand and chose him 5 smooth stones out of the brook and put them in the shepherd's bag which he had, even in a scrip, and his sling was in his hand, and he drew near the Philistine. And he, that's one, took his, that's two, staff in his, that's three, hand, and chose him, that's four, 5 smooth stones out of the brook and put them into the shepherd's bag which he, that's five, had, even in a scrip, and his sling, that's 6, was in his hand, that's 7, and he, that's 8, drew near to the Philistine. That's 8. 8 masculine pronouns.
There is not another verse in the whole Bible with 8 masculine pronouns or 8 feminine gender or 8 neuter genders. There isn't.
8 masculine pronouns. So John 16:13 and 1 Samuel 17:40 are unique. No other verses like these 2.
There is not another verse in the whole Bible with 8 masculine pronouns or 8 feminine gender or 8 neuter genders. There isn't.
Except the uni in unique means 1, not 2. Doesn't Allah is unique mean 1, only 1? Not 2, not both of him? And yet, here we have John 16:13 and 1 Samuel 17:40. What's a dead Deedat to do?
There is not another verse in the whole Bible with 8 masculine pronouns or 8 feminine gender or 8 neuter genders. There isn't.
Both have 8 masculine pronouns. Therefore, both must have the most male pronouns. I'm sure that is how Deedat would fix his proof. Deedat's proof is saved, stupid Christians. Both verses are unique. And both unique verses have the most male pronouns. Then it's a good thing there are no verses that have 9 masculine pronouns. Numbers 16:5. And he, that's 1, spake unto Korah, and unto all his company, that's 2, saying, even tomorrow the Lord will show who are his, that's 3, and who is holy and will cause him, that's 4, to come near unto him, that's 5, even him, that's 6, whom he, that's 7, hath chosen will he, that's 8, cause to come near unto him, that's 9. That's 9. Not only is John 16:13 not unique, sharing a count of 8 masculine pronouns with 1 Samuel 17:40, 8 is not even the most, the highest pronoun count. So point 2 of Deedat's proof of Mohammed, the unique man of John 16:13, has pretty much been exploded. I have proven John 16:13 cannot be Muhammad. John 16:13 is not unique. Or do you now want to argue neither is Muhammad? Muhammad is not unique. What's a dead Deedat to do? What do you want to believe, brother? John 16:13 is not Muhammad. And I think you know, brother, just how important it is to prove Surah 7:157 and 7:158 are not lies. But at some point, brother, you must decide. Do you really want the truth? Or will you settle for Islam's claims and Deedat's provably false arguments?
There is not another verse in the whole Bible.
There isn't. There isn't. There isn't.
I pray that you would actually open your heart to God's guidance. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And again, big thanks to Sold Out for Jesus 37. For doing the legwork and keeping his eyes and ears open. This is a great find, brother.